Why is it that it seems so much easier, both physically but also mentally, to hold high power on a climb than on the flat?
You what?
Well, it's something I noticed back in the day when I was racing, was that I could hold higher power for longer uphill.
I'm not having any of that. See, I'm absolutely convinced I could do more power on the flat than I can uphill. I think we need to investigate this.
Before I got a power meter, I used to think that this difference was just a poor excuse by climbers who are crap at time trialing or sprinters who hate climbing.
Well, it is certainly plausible that it is an imagined power discrepancy. However, the explanation lies in the difference between power to weight ratio and power to drag ratio. Both of these are key factors in determining cycling performance.
But then I did finally get a power meter and I realised that I really couldn't hold the same power on the flat as uphill. Well, I was a bit annoyed, so I thought I'll just try harder. And I tried harder and I still couldn't do it. I thought I was just being lazy. Maybe it was just the time trial bike. Perhaps in an aero position, I just couldn't put out the same power. But then I tried doing time trial intervals uphill, yep, on the aero bars, and I could still get a higher power than on the flat. And if my body was capable of that many watts uphill for 45 minutes, why couldn't I do it in a time trial? It was really annoying.
Well, maybe the answer lies in motivation. Perhaps some riders subconsciously put out less effort on the terrain they know they're not as good at. I mean, I don't think it's the full explanation, but it could play a part.
That's worrying. One theory is that it's purely about gradient. So when your bike is at a different angle, it's easier to put out more power. But that seems funny to me, because if that were true, wouldn't we just change our bike position on the flat?
Maybe. Another answer lies in physics and physiology. The science of pedaling uphill is different to pedaling on the flat. And the difference is kinetic energy and muscular movement patterns.
Kinetic energy is the energy you have due to your speed. So when you're going faster, you have more of it. Much more, actually, because kinetic energy is proportional to the square of your speed.
So for example, when you're on the flat, the kinetic energy contained in you and your bike will be much higher than on a climb, when you're more likely to be going slower.
That kinetic energy is what helps you to overcome what's slowing you down, so drag and rolling resistance on the flat.
Whereas on the climb, you'll also have gravity working against you, as well as rolling resistance and drag. Also, you have less kinetic energy.
So if, for example, you were to stop pedaling on the flat, you don't slow down that much. Whereas, if you stop pedaling on a climb, you slow down really fast.
Emma, come on, that was seriously obvious.
Okay, yeah, I know, but bear with me, there's more to it than that. When you're doing an effort and trying to hold a certain power, whether it's on the flat or uphill, then obviously you don't deliberately stop pedaling, but there is a dead spot in your pedal stroke where effectively you do stop pedaling.
Yeah, on the flat though, your bike and you roll through that dead spot without any notable slowing down. So you only have a very short moment in which to fire your muscles to keep the speed topped up.
Whereas on a climb, you actually have to put out power around way more of the pedal stroke to keep the bike moving forward and stop yourself from stopping or even going backwards.
So even whilst pedaling at the same cadence, how you pedal on a climb versus how you pedal on the flat is completely different. Your muscular movement patterns are the main difference.
Yeah, and physiologically what that means is that you need lots of fast twitch muscle fibres to fire your muscles fast enough to put out a high power on the flat.
Yeah, and for big, long, hard climbs, your slow twitch muscle fibres will be more suited to getting up those big mountains.
That would make sense, because I reckon I am about as slow twitch as it gets.
Maybe that's just because you never trained your fast twitch fibres, Emma.
Yep, that is also a plausible explanation. I didn't much like training sprinting. I guess it's a good point that a lot of people train for what they're already good at rather than training at what they're weaker at. So although I probably had a genetic predisposition to be slow twitch, I think I reinforced it over the years.
Yeah, and with all the training I did to focus on the flat races that I wanted to excel in, I guess I just built up loads of fast twitch muscle fibres, which made me pretty useless at slogging myself up a big climb.
Guess it's just courses for horses, isn't it? Can I sit on your wheel on the way back to the hotel, please?
Only if you promise to drag me up the next climb.
Okay, deal. I hope this video helps you to feel better about yourself if you thought that you sucked at riding either on the flat or uphill.
And maybe it will even help you improve the discipline that you weren't so great at.
If you'd like to see how to train for steep climbs, you could click down here for this video.
Make sure you give us a big thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and check out the shop down here.